this morning's session in its entirety is available on YouTube at Vishuddhatma. If you just Google Vishuddhatma, it is there, and it will also be there at the website of dadabhagwan.de, selectively categorized, and it hovers YouTube site Akram Vignan Germany. The audio link also is available in its entirety without any splits for 2.5 hours daily for each session. Previous audio links have been separated into two sections, but in the last many sessions there has been only one audio link. As we see Puja Niruma joining us in the singing of Dada Bhagwan Sing Jai Jaikar Ho, as we see our Gnani in front of Lord Simandhar placing a garland over him. My Lord, our highest namaskars to you in the live presence of Absolute Soul Dada Bhagwan within me. And my Lord Sri Krishna, Pratyaksh Dada Bhagwan ni sakshi hai. હું આપને અત્યંત ભક્તિપૂર્વક નમસ્કાર કરું છું. ઇન ધ લાઈવ પ્રેઝન્સ ઓફ દાદા ભગવાન ધી એબ્સોલ્યુટ સેલ્ફ વિધિન આઈ એમ ડુઈંગ નમસ્કાર્સ ટુ યુ વિથ એક્સ્ટ્રીમ ડિવોશન એન્ડ ધ સેમ ટુ ઓલ ધ શિવ સ્વરૂપ્સ ઓલ એમ્બોડીમેન્ટ્સ ઓફ સેલ્વેશન ઓફ ધીસ યુનિવર્સ શિવસ એન્ડ માય લોર્ડ જ્ઞાની પુરુષ દાદાશ્રી. Our highest namaskars to from all of us to you for this magnificent exposition and experience of the direct experience of the Self through your Gnan Vidhi and the subsequent satsangs. As we see thousands of Mahatmas in front of us, namaskars to the pure souls within all of them and to Ma Amba. Hey Ma, make me sahaj, make me natural and simple, and without interfering intellect. Highest namaskars to Pujaniru Ma and Dada Shri. Ma Amba. Gnani turns and looks at all of us, very fresh, all ready for another advanced level understanding, is the best way to put it. Not advanced level study, but advanced level understanding is probably the best meaning of Parayan under the leadership of a current living Jnani. Jai Sachidanand. As our Jnani takes seat, and so I have taken off the live sound from you so that I can give you the direct English voiceover translation and interpretation of what the Jnani is saying to the world in Gujarati language. Dada Bhagwan Asim Jayakar Ho. As the Jnani looks at many of the questions that he is receiving, we have six rows that go as far back as the eyes can reach, thousands of Mahatmas here gathered in Dada Nagar Hall, the city of Dada Hall, just behind Simandar City, a solid steel construction building with sliding side doors which allows air and light as necessary, fans running on top. This is the rainy season that has just concluded. Pretty humid and hot, but everybody in this magnificent Parayan is not least concerned about it. Next, hello. Jai Sachidanand, the awareness of eternal is bliss. I bow to the Absolute Self who resides within you with deep devotion and continued namaskars and oneness. And as highest namaskars to all namaskars who are also in the gigantic hall, which is the main, and also those who are getting the live relay of this, whether in Gujarati, but also those who are getting it in English, I suppose. And Jai Sachidanand to those who are present here, but otherwise they'll say Jai Sachidanand to everyone. So everybody should understand invited pain, right? So if you're not included, don't... Everybody understands Vorili Delu Dukh, right? Stop begging pain, you see, stop... this was the final time that you actually created some pain for you and kind of ate pain. Don't eat pain that is not there, mental and verbal pain from others. You don't want to hurt anyone and you do not want to even beg for it from others, you see. Yes, live in pure energy of the bliss of the Self. Let us read further. Jai Sachidanand, page 209. Who is liable for provoking? This world is our own. No one else is liable or responsible here. If God were the boss, then we would know that we can wash off our sins simply by praying to Him. But it is not like that. We are whole and soul responsible here. One is indeed liable for each and every single wrong thought. You are whole and soul responsible for sure. Even the single wrong thought, there carries a liability. That thought, if it is person, a human being, is about human being, it will reach that human being, those vibrations. And then it begins the complications. Keep it separate. Our role is to keep it separate. There is no boss sitting high up there somewhere. Whatever there is simply you only. Only as individuals does everyone suffer, but really they are all pure souls. And so the other person too is a God. God resides within all. So do not trouble or provoke Chanchedvu anyone. Try and help everyone if you can. It is fine if you can't do it, but do not provoke anyone. It's a very... Don't even call anyone. But now, if you want to help, then help. But do not, you know, He is like this, he is like that. Don't, Sancheva means to be in the negativity or to promote the negativity of anyone. After all, they are all gods. They are pure souls, you see, and they are gods. God is beyond pure soul, but they are all gods and pure souls only. But you see, the whole idea that he did this to me, so I'm going to get back to him. Then until you find a liberation, that will bother you. People do not provoke tigers and or poisonous snakes. So then why do they provoke humans? Because people know that the tiger and the snake can kill them. But they do not hesitate to provoke humans, because the worst a person will do is to beat him with a stick. That is why they provoke people. But you cannot incite anyone, because Paramatma, the Absolute Self, resides within every living being. Do you understand this fact? Have you ever provoked anyone? And answer, people do that to the one who works under them. Rather, she says, as long as you have a habit of abusing as a boss those who are under your control, you will come across somebody who will do the same to you. This is the principle. This is the absolute principle. If you hurt somebody, they will hurt you. If you put somebody in trouble, you will be put into trouble. If you help someone, you will get pleasure. And if you become vitrak, people will be vitrak towards you and let you go to with moksha only. I never scold anyone, therefore no one scolds me. Our energy is not for suppressing those. I never scold anyone, therefore no one scolds me. This is what I don't give pain to anyone. I do not beg for anyone, so nobody gives me pain. You see now. But this is very beautiful, because this is the Siddhant. This is the one principle that works from all angles. You see, if you have any expectations, then no one will expect anyone from you. The world is your own mirror. You see, if you have expectations, people will expect from you. This is the final Siddhant, that I do not beg for anybody's pain, and therefore no one gives pain from me. I don't have any opinions about anyone, then no one will have any opinion for you. If you don't scold anyone, no one will scold you. These are all Siddhants, incontrovertible principles. Our energy is not for suppressing those below us. They are for getting our work done by keeping them happy. We feed 10 rupees worth of grass to the bull, and exactly 30 rupees of worth of work from him is extracted from him. Similarly, these farm hands will work for you only if they get something out of you, right? But if you mistreat or abuse them repeatedly, where would they go? God resides in all creatures, but in humans, he is in a manifest form. It may not be the absolute manifestation of God, Parameshwar or Paramatma. Nonetheless, it is God, Ishwar. You see, the difference which is given here, the God who is capable of doing anything. Therefore, they do not disturb him. That's the definition of Ishwar, and Ishwar can do anything. This is why I say adjust everywhere. It is not worth disadjusting with anyone. This world is worth escaping from. Our Gnana is capable of taking one to moksha in one or two lifetimes. So get your work done. Ishwar means if he decides to kill you, he will kill you. That is the kind of energies he has. Get our the science is going to take you. Get your work done, you see. This, if a person gets provoked, even if he gets the slightest pain, even if a little ant gets paid, it will bite you. You see, so do not hurt anyone. And if it happens, then it will bind an account with you. Where? V-E-Y-R, a revenge account with you. And if it will believe that, you know, if I had a stick, I would hit him back, you know. He changes his intentions for you. And human beings have a siddhi, the accomplishments that they can do whatever they desire. That is called Aishwarya. And the difference between Aishwarya, that is because there is God, the Self resides within him. And Parameshwar is the Absolute One, the No Lord God, the Paramatma only, the pure Knower-Seer only. Nature may help him if he wants to hurt you. He wanted to hurt you because you had hurt him. Therefore, these are all vibrations reaching each other. These are all attacks and counter-attacks only. That is what is happening in this world. But you see, they take revenge. And when revenge is given, then again they bind new revenge. So they suffer and they revenge, suffer and revenge, suffer and vengeance continues. So get your work done with the understanding. Just live with love with other human beings. Do not hurt anyone. This is very important. And slowly, get your work done. Move in the directions of the Paramatma within you. Who is at fault in this questioner? My nature is such that if I get angry because I cannot tolerate anything wrong, the other she says, who decides that this is wrong? Questioner, I follow and do what the intellect tells me. The other she says, yes, it judges to that extent. Questioner, but if I am paying 25 rupees per day to someone and if he hardly does any work worth 5 rupees, then I feel that it is not right. This is your own, you have just decided what is right according to your own intellect and belief, is it not? This wrong belief is the one, this is the more, or because of our own beliefs and our own opinions is the reason why we get the suffering. But why do you think he is not doing the work? What is the reason behind him not working properly? The question that it is because he is lazy by nature. The other she says, does everyone get such a person to work for him? Question, and how can I say that everyone gets such a person? The other she says, why is that you amongst all had to get such a person? There must be a reason behind that, no? My past karma must be like that. That is why he met me. The other she says, so who is at fault? But what is his fault? So then, where is the reason to get angry with him at all? Be angry with yourself and ask yourself, what kind of karma did I bind that I got such a person to work for me? The weakness of an individual hurts him only. This is the important thing. The weakness of an individual hurts him only. The weakness of an individual. The fault is of the sufferer. Then why do... When you do anger because he does not do his work, then causes you pain. So the mistake lies with you. He will remain as he is. He will do the same thing tomorrow. On top of that, he will make fun of you as you turn around. He will say, leave him alone. He is crazy. So I'm writing ahead now. This is the weakness of the individual hurts him only. This is the fault is of the sufferer. Dada Shri has given us the vision of the Gnani, of liberation only. As, but otherwise, you when the suffering mode, you say people are like this, they never even work for worth the money that you are paying them. They take shortcuts, etc. All kinds of opinions bind you, all kinds of illusory attachment make you magnify your own pain, magnify your... But if you have the reason, if you have the understanding that fault is of the sufferer, there is no way, you have to finish the karma that you have created in the past life only. Okay. So I should sit with him and reason with him that why is it not possible for you to do this much work? See how much more other people are doing, and if he does not know how, then I can teach him. Should I do something like that? The other she says, yes, should explain to him such a way that he can understand. Positive feelings will arise in him and he'll be encouraged to do the work. So I have already read this part. Okay. The other she says, yes, explain to him in this way. Positive feelings is lagni. A subordinate may become benevolent for you. If someone is working for you, never be contemptuous or scornful towards him, tarchod, or provoke him. Treat everyone with respect. You never know what you may benefit from some human being. Today you benefited a lot through this person. You got introduced to me and that verily is a great benefit. This benefit is one which you have never gotten before, apurva. You gain something that you had never even before heard of in all the previous lives. Therefore, do not provoke anyone, not even a dog sitting around in front of you. If the dog were to chase someone, he may run and take shelter in our home and then give us satsang someday. If that dog were to chase a Gnani Purush, then the Gnani Purush would look for shelter and he will get into someone's home. See, that dog is also helpful, isn't he? Everything in this world is potentially helpful. Paramatma, Absolute Self, resides in everybody. And every living being is in your service day and night. One does not know how to use that service to his benefit. wherever you look, never disturb anyone, never incite anyone, never provoke anyone. Be interactive in the world so that no one will be hurt by you as the short, scornful, contemptuousness. When you are in authority, there chances are that you will abuse others. So this is why, you see, the worldly interaction is of one of exchange of money. I am giving you the salary, you have to work. But you see, then, so you have to recognize that if he does the work, you do not have the right to disturb his ego or create kashais, because you are trying to feed your own kashais within you, that I am the boss, I know superior, I want to, I am the doer, etc. That is the pain of man, your status, and therefore you are, wherever you look, there is nothing but boss, boss and boss only. And you are the boss of someone too. A boss keeps chastising his underhand and works him to death. He would not even let him rest in peace. So we should live in such an equitable life. Live such an equitable life that no one gets hurt to the slightest extent. The boss should not get hurt, and the subordinate should not get hurt. No one. So you should live it to such an extent, underlying the sentence as Deepak Bhai, you should live, and the boss should not get hurt, and the children should not get hurt at home. In order to live such a life, we should get our machinery overhauled by a Jnani Purush. Get your machine overhauled. Have you ever brought a tender, a statement of a price at which one is ready to undertake a certain work for an overhaul? Have you ever brought a tender for an overhaul? The questioner, the language of the contractor comes forth even in your speech. Yes, it will come out like that. Only contracting was our business, so we would know things like a tender and all that. How can you afford to have a superior? If I paid as much respect to God and bow down to him as much as I do to my boss, I would be liberated by now, says the questioner. Radharshi says, yes, you would be liberated. Even if you were to bow down to God by that much, you will have your solution, because there is no shortage in the home of the Lord. People do not like bowing to their boss, but what can they do? They have to make a living somehow, and that is mandatory. So bow to the boss. You have to accept his verbal abuse and get on with your work. The boss would have left his home in anger, and then he takes out his anger on you at work. I had this thought at the age of 13, that if I were to have a boss over me, how was I going to put up with it? The boss would scold me without reason. It would be acceptable if his anger was justified, but if he took his anger out on me just because he was irritated with his wife or somebody else, that would not be acceptable. That is why I never liked the idea of a boss over me. So I decided to look for God. I cannot put up with a boss, said Dada. It is only the humans that have to work hard till the end of their lives. But when these cows and bulls get old, they are taken to animal shelters. Only the humans have the problem of having to run around till the end of their life. So is it better to quit the job, Dada? Dada, she says, no, it is not good to do the job. It is also not good to leave the job. The family may suffer if you quit, and you may be frustrated if you do not. So why don't you let your things run as they are? When the job is gone on its own, then it is good. When our joints become weak and old, even the children will be disrespectful and abusive. Where is the pleasure in this? These are all tasks of vairagya, dispassion. But we had seen all this. There are many people who says, oh, I don't want to work. They even come and say, I want to leave my job so that I can be in Akram Vignan or help out. No, you don't have to do the work, nor do you have to leave the work. Let it happen on its own. It is part of the account of the non-self complex only. And so you have to go to your work, the job, the service, and be subservient to your boss. Say hi to him. Be in his vinay, in his humility too. Because who is the servant here? Uva and Nada is the servant. I am the boss only. I am I'm the pure soul, neither the boss nor the servant. When our joints become weak and old, even the children will be disrespectful and abusive. When you become a certain old of certain age, then even people, your own sons and daughters, will be abusive to you. Where is the pleasure in this? These are all talks of vairagya, dispassion, but we had seen all this, says Dada. That is when you realize that this is truly bondage. We felt this bondage very early in life. We did not like anyone above us as the boss or upri. I used to have to go to other teachers to study, and I tolerated that with great difficulty. From home, they would kick the football and say, go to school, and the school teacher will kick the football and say, go home. One's state becomes like a football. So is one likely to like any boss? At the moment, there is no boss in this world over us, Dada Shri. There is no boss in this world over us. Us means, how can one afford to have a superior over him? So am I not making you superior free, and yet I do not want to be anyone's superior? One cannot dismiss a subordinate. I am making you superior free, and yet I do not want to be anyone's superior. Next heading, one cannot dismiss a subordinate. That is why, just because we hear the others talk about go home and go to school, go to study, we don't want to make any changes. We just have to, yes, you have to send your child to school, you know, but this is the internal thing. Dada Shri says that I used to feel the burden of going to school because I had that load until I became enlightened in 1958. When your own mistakes are broken naturally, then no one will hurt you. And he was able to give the Shuddhatma Pad, the state of the Shuddhatma, to us all too. And through that state, we can remove the fulfill and be free from the remaining accounts, you see. We do not need to make any changes in the life of the relative file one at all. One cannot dismiss a subordinate is the next heading. Sanjay Bhai asking a question. Supposing you get a master or a superior in life, the other had such high revolutions, he had higher revolutions than any teacher of his, and therefore he could not tolerate any boss as a teacher even. Even if he looks at a book, he will know the whole book entirely. And you know, every day the teacher going A, B, C, D, E, F, G, you know, how can he tolerate that? He had such a high revolution of the intellect. Yes, but also, but you know, yes, he went all the way. He studied 15 years. He went to school. He studied until the 10th grade, SSC, Standard School Certificate. One cannot dismiss a subordinate. Questioner, those who have authority should not abuse their authority or hurt those who are below them. Below them means underhand, below you. They are subordinates to you. The word in Gujarati, which has been adopted by Gujaratis, is underhand, the one below me. So you hurt the hearts of those who are under you, underhand it is called. There is no English word called underhand really, but it is the subordinate, the one who is below you. Questioner, Dada, my job is in the police department. There is a lot of corruption in our department and it involves me too. Dada Shri, these corrupt people are sowing rotten seeds, and so even in the leaves that sprout, there is rot only. They have holes in them. Have you not seen that? Do some leaves not have holes? Is it not a wonder? Honest people have difficulties because of these people. The corrupt one will not let the honest one live in a normal life. They then shun them as if they are detestable. Even their superior would not know that here comes interference and trouble. Honest and sincere people have trouble everywhere. However, ultimately, nature and God are always with the honest person. Okay. The honest person. The one who is ultimately God as well as Kudrat, the nature, is on the side of the honest one. At a high position in government, when a subordinate commits a lot of illegal things, then we have to decide to take some steps and dismiss him, says the questioner. Dadashri says, you should not dismiss him. You should inform him in this way. You should not be doing this. However, this is a government department, so you cannot dismiss him at all, especially in India. When you work for the government, you cannot fire people and take away their jobs. You make him realize his mistakes, of in what way he is hurting others by doing what he is doing. Do you have anybody over you who can dismiss you or not? Surely there is someone, Dada. So then you should not undertake the liability of firing someone. If your superior tells you to fire him, even then you should water down your approach, make your approach milder. Even if you have to tell a lie, pardon me, when it comes to your own dismissal, you would not like to hear the word dismissed, would you? Would it not affect you a lot? Yes, it would. It would hurt me. It would hurt everyone. Dadashri says, that is how affected that poor fellow would be, would he not? Why should we hurt anybody in this world? Follow the laws. There are all kinds of loopholes within the law. And is there not a milder language that you can use? Is there not a difference between saying, please explain to me why you should not be dismissed, or between, I will dismiss you, therefore you should use soft language. So this is your liability and responsibility. It is a great liability that a mistake is being committed from your side. You may have to lie at times in order to save a person's livelihood. Even the British government had laws on books where if someone was sentenced to be hanged at 3:45 p.m., again, it got delayed by 1 second, the prisoner would have to be stopped. The imprisonment, the time had to be observed very precisely. You cannot stop the act. Despite this, the hanging would have to be stopped is the correct. And despite this, there was a law that if a justice of peace was walking by the scene and he saw this, the prisoner had to be set free. There have been instances when it was arranged for the justice of peace to pass by, several persons were set free. So if someone has to be dismissed, let him escape the dismissal, even if you have to lie to do so. After that, there is no need to have any second thought or guilty feelings. Tell a lie so that someone becomes free. The influence of important people works all the way to the gates of God's house, but not beyond the gates. And after that, there is no need to have any second thoughts or guilty feelings. The influence of important people works all the way to the gates of God's house, but not beyond that. The government knew that certain people influenced the JP to walk by the hanging executions, but the law is law. Now, if the JP's eyes can bring about this benefit, what is it that cannot be accomplished by this, by the eyes of the Gnani Purush? Everybody clapping here. So that is the end of the chapter here. The one who loses his job, he will bind such a vengeance with you that I will take care of you. That person does not know what he did to deserve the being fired, but he will bind such wear and vengeance with you, V-E-Y-R, wear and vengeance with you, that he will not leave you alone. So he is not doing it. It is his karma that made him lose his job. But why should you exercise your ego saying that I will fire you and do anything to fire him? You should try your level best not to fire him. The karma is making you do this and the other person do this, but you should have the internal understanding that you wish you do not, you might soften your approach to people who are below you. But don't dismiss anyone. Dadashri says that I'm going to be right back. Let's clear the throat. So Shuddha is back now. Sorry about the interruption. Verse, you see, after having done his deeds, he is repentant inside. That is the first step. He should repent. To believe that I am the father, that is a blunder, and to hurt your children as a father is the mistake. But the person says that I do not want to have anyone above me. I do not want to become a boss of anyone, therefore always keep somebody above. The Dada says that I am not above you, but it is a good thing. Our Param Vinaya is such absolute humility, said that Dada is above me. That is, yes, and you can establish your Dada Bhagwan, Gnani Purush Dada Shri as your Upri, or your current Gnani as your Upri, you see. This is this. Your soul, but inside, yeah, there is one. Inside, you should have the same sense of oneness as that my Lord Dada and Dada Shri and my Gnani, your Absolute Self, is the same as my Absolute Self. But if you do not have the relative understanding by keeping him above you in the relative, then you see that you might risk going into your own directions on your Swachanda, your own intellect-guided, willful behavior, you see. But here the Gnani, the living Gnani, is not your opri, he is not your boss, but you know, in worldly interactions, it is a good idea to always be under him. And but you know, sometimes he says that I will ask for the, yes, you can, I will ask for this energies to become free by asking for pratikraman, by doing pratikraman, Dada or Niruma, but escaping from Deepak Bhai. But you see, but Dada Shri, Deepak Bhai says, without keeping a living Gnani in front of you as your Upri, it is impossible to get liberated. In Akram, everyone has to keep the living Gnani as your Upri, as your boss. It's like this, you know, out of this million stars in the sky, who will show you the northern star in exactness, you see? Because, you know, the awareness may slip, you know? You never know whether it's your awareness that is working or it is your intellect that is working at a very subtle level in many times. Therefore, always keep the living Gnani as your superior, you see? And you see, for me, it is all day Niruma and Dada is above me, and for you, you should have the current living Gnani as above you, is the answer given to Ketan by the Aptaputra there. Otherwise, it is very difficult to progress. Niruma had kept Dada every second as her boss. And then she was following the agnas of Dada only. Even after Dada was not present, she always kept Dada above her head. Even when Dada was not physically present, she kept Dada as her superior. Next one. So now Sanjay asking, so when? When Mahatmas keep you as their superior and you keep Dada Bhagwan as your superior, what is the difference? The living Nani gives you the practical solutions. Yes. When I make you understand, then I had read this at home. And when I had read that Vorayartheno Dukh, you see, the fault is of the sufferer, the one who invites the mistakes, that is his fault. But last night, but there's something newer arose the night before, you see. So that time I realized that when I read this in exactness, then I got a new unfolding of the invited pain. Up until now, I had the old understanding. And then my understanding was the fault is of the sufferer, but then I realized that vareth anudok, but if I take on the pain, then I will get the pain. But if I don't take on anybody's pain, then I will not be hurting anyone. You see, but up until then, I was always had the sense that there is a tendency to abuse this particular sentence of the invited pain and the begging the pain. But it was only until recently that I realized that, and then I got the final answer to this. My question is, but on the line of demarcation, my question is, Okay, one, you are on the line of demarcation. At what level are you keeping Dada Bhagwan as your upari? Because if you are on this line of the line of demarcation, you are exactly seven, then why do you, at what level do you keep? He says, if the mistakes are over. No, the mistakes are not over. Very subtle level, the mistakes are still. We don't know what subtle roots are still lying. So therefore, till the last minute, you have to keep somebody as your superior. You have to keep your Gnani as your superior. But you see, I have a lot remaining, but I'm asking again, Sanjay is coming, if I keep you as my superior, but somebody, what is the difference between this who does not have any kind of sense that I'm the body? I keep my Dada Bhagwan within me as myself. You see, he just, you know, you see, Dada himself has said that I'm at 356, that I keep Dada Bhagwan as my superior. Gnani Purush Dada Shri used to say that I keep my Dada Bhagwan within me as my superior. He knows that he still has to, he is still at the level of the awareness, and the Lord is absolutely and continuously aware, and therefore there is a lot of difference that until I'm continuously as the self, then I don't need any. When I am one with Dada Bhagwan within me, then I don't have to have any superior. But when I am interacting with somebody, then I have to have the Dada Bhagwan within me as my superior. This is it. This is how it is. When we keep you as our superior, it is because of our mistakes. But you are beyond mistakes, so who do you keep as your superior? Yes, of course there are mistakes of Deepak, and therefore I keep Dada Bhagwan as my superior, says Deepak Bhai. Yes, I have become a Shuddhatma by Nishchay, but my worldly interaction, yes, there are certain mistakes, and therefore I tell Dada Bhagwan within me, Dada Bhagwan, please forgive me for what has happened. But the Sukshmatar mistakes are there, so that lets me see that some mistakes have happened, but other people will not be able to pick up that the mistake has happened. But I am aware that mistakes are happening. I am not the... Yes, only my own stock that is coming up. By relative viewpoint, I am still Deepak, am I not? I have not become a perfect Paramatma yet. By relative viewpoint, I am still a Deepak. And by real viewpoint, I am what I am. That is what the answer is. Yes. And inside I am one with my Dada Bhagwan within me. That is how it is. Let us move forward. And now let us go to the next chapter. Chapter 17. Was your pocket picked? The resolution. What are the facts behind the robbery? Nature is always just. Not even for a moment has it been unjust. Justice that prevails in law. Somebody is asking a question, Pragna. But then, what is the responsibility of the boss? What is the responsibility of the father? The fathers and the parents, the mother is the responsibility is to nurture the child all the way. In the same way, the boss's responsibility is to nurture those who are below you. Yes, if you are giving, yes, but if you are giving the salary, then you take the work. But in that, there should be no kashais. That is called, but to abuse him, to make him suffer mentally, that is wrong. That is not the contract. The contract is to just extract the work and to get the work for the money that you pay him. But you have no right to hurt or abuse him in any way. The best thing, of course, is that you should, if you try to investigate why is he not able to do the work that he has been assigned, study that. What is his problems? You see, he should understand the importance of the work that you believe is important to be done. He too should understand the importance of that work. But if you do bossism, a new word, if you do bossism, you exercise your bossness over him, if you are abusive towards him, even if... But you see, in worldly interaction, you may know that I am his boss, but you see, you should not have the slightest sense that I am superior to him in any way. Then your ego will not hurt him. Then he too will open up his doors for you and try to do his best for you. But it is our ego that I am the boss, I am in a superior position. He must listen to me, otherwise I will be blamed, etc. It is our ego that is hurting the other person, not your role. Boss means the servant of servant, that is his. Husband means the wife of the wife, that is the definition of Dada. When we when we have to point out a mistake to somebody above you, our own boss, how humble we are, you know. And now, if he was supposed to sign 10 checks and he forgot to sign one because of your mistake, will he not tell you, aren't you stupid? Why didn't you get them signed properly when you brought all the checks to me? And so, go take it back. And so, when you tell the servant, oh, go take this check back and get the signed. You know, in India, there is a lot of back and forth of the middleman. Go to him, send this back to him, and send this back to him. A lot of bureaucratic work where the servant suffers from both ends. He's like a soccer ball that is being kicked between two people only. You see, but try to be respectful to the person who is working for you, that's all. He may be your errand boy, he may be just your jockey, but you see, you have no reason to hurt him. You see, he is working like a jockey, he's working like somebody who is just your simple errand boy, because he has no other recourse. He has to take this minimal salary that you're giving him so that he can bring food to his family and himself. So be kind. Do not hurt the knocker. No, do not hurt the servant. Yeah, behave in such a way that you do not hurt anyone. As long as you have the opinion that the servants are like this, and if I am not harsh with them, they will not improve. The servants will continue to find faults with you and will take shortcuts and not do it them this way. If you are sincere to them, they will be sincere to you. That is the law of nature. You see, Deepak Bhai says that in my own company, as a contractor, as an engineer of a mechanical engineer to improve machine, other people's machines, you know, people who used to work with me, they were very sincere to me because I was sincere to them. I was nice to them. I was kind to them. I would not hurt their ego. Yes. But you see, they used to tell me that I'd rather work for you, Deepak Bhai, than for anybody else because I like the way you treat me. You see, this is the... But you know, this is... That's not called respecting them, but it is actually, you know, he has his own son and little boy to feed, does he not? So you should not be hurting even the person who takes the least amount of salary from your company and works for you. You see, he is actually your superior and get the work done. He knows that he has to work, but you do not have the right to give him the extra item by abusing him through the words. Then later on he will become inflexible, and then he will become naughty, and he will not really do his work properly. In the initial days when you are his boss, he is always subservient to you. He wants to do your work. But when he finds that you do not have any kind of substance within you, that you yourself are a nonsense person, then he gets bad. And he says, then, now, I have one question. The one who is reading, not to dismiss anyone. When somebody is doing a lot of hurt to the society, and lot of people are getting hurt towards him, and if I see that, and so he continues to be the chua, should I support him as a boss, and all our understanding is coming to failure, then should we not dismiss him? Are we not being unjust to the world, is it? And now Deepak Bhai says that we catch the path that Dada has given us. You see, there is no wicked man in this world. He is wicked and he is evil because of his understanding. You know, the entire staff can do the right kind of prayers for him, bring him under right understanding, and because of his own understanding, once he comes under pain, then he will turn a good man from a bad man. And your approach is your view, but we follow the approach of Jnani Purush Dada Shri and Dada Bhagwan within. You know, if you try to control his external activity, if he is disturbed inside, he will continue to do it one way or the other. Our way is what we have just been accept. We should enter into penance. And penance and prayer is the only way to improve the other person. Penance and prayer is the only way to improve the other person. But if it is, there is an energy within that man, that man is doing the wrong things with the wrong, that same energy which is going the wrong way, when it turns in the right way, will be very beautiful. When he gets the right kind of guide, then he will do that same energy that was going in the wrong direction as a wicked person, as an evil act, will become the most beautiful human being. And you see, you never know how it will change, you see. In the nature, you know, nature has brought us to this shibir. Why is it that, but supposing you are not here in the shibir and you are in the wrong place, why did we encounter such a place that somebody took us to, out of this satsang? Our path is the path of internal penance and love only. And there is, we never even dream of dismissing anyone. We never even listen to our mistakes in these matters. He is a pure, and he can send the pure energies to his pure soul within that person only. But you see, it is through ignorance that we hurt the other person. So we should be very careful about this. We do not want to hurt anyone through ignorance at all. We should not. So you should, you know, don't try to find in which way I find him guilty, and I want to get him out of this work. You know, you will find such people today. Fire him all the way, but where is the one who changes in his internal understanding the natural way? You see, and, you know, even if he is evil, he may be going to God, and he might be putting 5 rupees for the benefit of the world by offering this money to the God. You see, so, or he might be also giving some money to a beggar outside his home. So, if you can find something positive within somebody who is so-called doing wicked acts or evil acts, you see, you know. You will help him a lot, and he too, he must be repenting from inside when he is doing such wicked or evil acts and hurting a lot of people. But you should not be joining the crowd that is throwing the stones at him. You should not be joining the crowd that is throwing. Find the right way only. Let us find the right way only. You see, when Dadashu says that we should become so such that the guilty one will never make any mistakes, the evil man will become a good man. This is how what we have to be, that is, we have to suffer the inner penance until then. Do not try to improve him at all. And the only way to help the other person is to have not have a slightest negative intention or bhav or view or outlook towards him. Leave alone vocalizing it to others. Always have the purest intentions towards him. Do not harbor the slightest negativity towards him. You see, people who are heavy drunkards and who are heavily hurting the society, etc., they have not become like that. They have been thrown in that position by the society. The society has hurt them in such a way. They have not become evil on their own. The society and others have thrown him in that corner, in a deep corner where they cannot come out. So understand this in correctness, slowly, because he is a pure soul. Even though he is a wicked one, or even though he is an evil person, he is a pure soul. Remember that, know that. Now the heading, was your pocket picked? Resolution. What are the facts behind the robbery? Nature is always just. Not even for a moment has it been unjust. Justice that prevails in the law courts may be unjust at times, but there is nothing unjust in this. Therefore, stealing done by prominent people is correct. Black marketing carried out by people is also correct. So and so will happen to the black market is correct, and its outcome in the black market is also correct. Therefore, nature does everything exactly according to the natural law. It does not go outside that law at all. Nature has not been unjust even for a second. Questioner, so the one suffering pleasure or pain now will pay for it later. Is that so? The Adashri says, it is not a matter of suffering or not suffering. Nature is continuously dealing out justice or punishing the guilty. People generally offer consolation to someone whose pocket has been picked. They will say, have some tea, do this and do that. But what does nature say? It says the guilty one is the one whose pocket has been picked. He got caught today for his past crime. How is it that two out of the two people sitting together, he is the one whose pocket gets picked? It means that he has been apprehended today for the crime he committed in the past life. The pickpocket will be charged for his crime whenever he gets caught. Right now he is suffering pleasure. The one who gets robbed is suffering, therefore he is at fault. Such is nature's law, and this is unlike the law of the courts. The fault is of the sufferer. You should see who is the one crying right now. Know that the guilty one is the one who is crying now. The law of the world is different. So what does the law of nature say? Fault is of the sufferer. So do not complain. This is very deep talk. If one understands just this much, if he thinks deeply, it can take him all the way to moksha. And if he sees through his intellect, buddhi, he will never be able to escape the worldly life. From the fact that the law of fault is of the sufferer, you should know that if you are suffering, then it is your own fault and it is the path. And this is the path to moksha. So I am just finished this reading paragraph. One is not bound by anything in this world. If you have to live in the midst of hundreds of thousands of robbers and you are asleep with lot of money in your pocket, not one robber will be able to touch your pocket. That is how just this world is. And the regulator of this world is so precise that it keeps the world regulated. It isn't hollow talk when I say that the world's regulator keeps everything within its system, niyam, within its law. It is these kashais, anger, pride, deceit and greed, that are the cause of one's pain. No one on the outside is giving you any pain. These kashais, anger, pride, deceit and greed teach you that this is pain. They mislead you. Otherwise, on the outside, no one is at fault at all in this world. Questioner, this is beautiful science coming up in front of you. Our own anger, pride, deceit and greed makes us see that this person is wrong. He did it. He is guilty one. I am pure. I am clean and he is the guilty one. He is tainted. I am pure. Etc. But for the one who is, I shouldn't use the word pure, but I am good, I am not guilty, etc. But you see, his fault is the sufferer, and whatever has happened is justice, our magnificent understanding to really prevail within ourselves. You see, the regulator of the world is, nature is the regulator of the world. It brings all this, it brings the evil man in front of the good man, you see. And so these are the two with the account. A good man is good in this life, but he is not necessarily good in a previous life, you see. And you don't know how his account is going to unfold, you see. And so the one who is cutting the pocket and the one whose pocket is being picked, the one who is being robbed in his home, their accounts have been made in the previous lives, the contracts have been made in the previous life, and that account is unfolding at a certain time when the evidences are correct in this life. And so, but by then blaming the other person when it happens, he is creating another account for next life, you see. And so if you do not, but if you have not given the pain back, then no, there is no power on this earth that can touch you. So we need to understand this mistake, you see, that the world is such that whatever has happened is justice and the fault is of the sufferer. And you see, and so, but you see, when you revenge and take revenge, then you will never become free from it. It is this questioner, does this mean that the fault is of our karma? That is, just says, no, you are the culprit yourself, not your karma. No one is at fault. If your pocket gets picked, it gets picked because of your own fault and not because of anyone else. All your accounts from the past life are being cleared now. The one who picked your pocket may be having fun right now, but today you have been caught. This is the science of spirituality in exactness, says Deepak. This is the spiritual science in exactness. You know, people talk about spiritual science, but this is the spiritual science in front of us. But for the one who wants to go to moksha, wants to get liberated, he will have to accept these under this understanding. If someone borrows, questioner asking, 25,000 rupees from me and does not pay me back, is that also karma from my past life that is being cleared? Dadashri says, everything is an account of karma, so don't worry. Do not become angry with him if you run into him. Otherwise, you will be binding more karma with him over and over about the money that you have lost. So, should I then say, let him have the money? Dadashri says, you are not to say, let him have it. You should remain quiet there. If you say, let him have it, that too is a fault. You should understand from within that this is a result of your own mistake from a previous life. However, you should not say that to him. Otherwise, that will encourage him not to return the money. On his face, live in front of him, you have to only say this, at least pay me back whatever amount is convenient to you. Tell him this much, but within you should know that if the money is returned, it is well and good, and if it is not returned, even then there is no problem. But you have to ask. No one comes across another person without an account. Why was it that you lent the money to that individual and no other person? That is why it is an account. No one will meet you without an account. We see the entire world as flawless or nirdosh, says Gnani Purush Dadashri. Everyone is flawless. It is our mistake that we find faults. Sooner or later, will you not have to see this world as flawless? If you understand just this much, that all this is due to my own accounts, then it will help you a lot. The self, Atma, does not have a pocket. If you are the self as capital, you have no pocket that can be picked. If you are the Atma, you have no pocket that can be picked. And so, it is. Chandubhai, Uve's pocket has been picked, but you say, my pocket has been picked, and so you become Uva, you become Chandubhai. This is the illusion, this is the wrong belief, this is Mithyatva, this is Bhranti, this wrong belief, Mithyatva. This is the wrong vision. When you say, I am being hurt, he hurt me, that is Mithyatva. When you are the pure soul, you are not Katya, but when you say, she hurt me, that is Mithyatva, wrong vision. This is the exact Siddhant, the exact principle of liberation. You see, when you become separate from the one whose pocket who got hurt, who was hurt in this world, then you have entered the world of liberation, you see. This is the exact vision, and with this vision, the Gnani Purush Dadashri saw the world flawless. With this vision, this was the vision of Gnani Purush Dadashri, you see, when you are a pure soul and when your pocket gets picked, then, and you do not get affected, then you are truly a Shuddhatma, a pure soul. But when you suffer even to the slightest extent, then to that extent you are a little bit Katya, a little bit Uve, a little bit Nada. That is the I-ness, that is the Potapanu, that is the I-ness. The I-ness has to go away. I-ness is the sense that I am, this happened to me. In these four sentences, the entire Vijnan is opening for us. In every ways, it is opening up for us. The one who is suffering is not I. The one who is suffering is not I at all. I am not this person. I am the eternal blissful one only. And why did this person, the file one, got the suffering? Why did Uwe get the suffering? This is because there is some residual mistake of the last life that is still remaining. That is why it is happening. Questioner, I am asking, as someone who is living the worldly life, what am I to do when I know and also see that my pocket is being picked? Dadashri says, your response at present, when he is picking your pocket, would be, why are you picking my pocket? You will get angry and curse him and beat him up. And are you asking what you should really do? So what I am saying is, when he is cutting your pocket, you should remember what the Lord says, that it is the unfolding of my karma. Otherwise, why would this man pick my pocket with 5,000 rupees and not the other one with only the 200 rupees? What positive opportunity are you presented with when he is picking your pocket? It is an opportunity to rise to the highest dharma dhyan, absence of adverse internal meditation. But instead you do raudra dhyan, a severe internal meditation that hurts the self as well as others. When your pocket is being picked, it is the unfolding of your own karma. You have the opportunity to enter into the best dharma dhyana at that time. When your pocket is being picked, it is the unfolding of your own karma that has brought the pickpocket to you. And instead of the pocket with the 200 rupees, the one with the 500 rupees has come into his account. All this is settlement of your account. All this is more details of the Agna of Vyavasthit, you see. Questioner. Question, you have been given the solution for the fact, but what should I do at the very instant the pocket is being picked? Should I try to stop him or let him go ahead and let him cut it? The other she says, you should not let him cut the pocket. Then what should I do when I know that this guy is picking my pocket? Now, if you see him doing it, then catch him. But having caught him, do not have any Raudra Dhyan towards him, anger towards him. You can tell him, dear fellow, why are you picking my pocket? What wrong have I done to you? If you are hard pressed, here, take 100 rupees, I am giving it to you. I have to settle an account with these 5000 rupees. I need the 5000 rupees to settle my own accounts. There is nothing wrong in giving him 50 to 100 rupees, but settle with him peacefully. You have to catch him for sure. You cannot take the approach, go ahead and cut it, dear fellow. My God, my Lord says, Dada Bhagwan says, go ahead and cut. You can't do that, but it is futile to get angry and create turmoil after he cuts your pocket and to complain and make a big fuss. There is nothing wrong when a pickpocket picks a pocket. Not even for a moment has this world functioned outside the law, nature's law. Yet people say, people have become unworthy today. They are all useless. Nobody has become unworthy and unworthy at all. Nature makes all these things happen, and these people are only instruments or nimit in the process. But they do egoism that I did it. They do egoism that I did it, that is all. So do not look for anybody's faults, because if you do, then you will incur a karmic liability, a new account. You do not want to take on the liability, do you? Next heading, nature's awesome planning. Pocket picking is an art of a kind. What would happen if all the pickpockets in this world are rounded up and killed? The world will be in disorder. What happens if you pull out the clarinet player from the music band? The band music will come out of tune. Likewise, you need the entire orchestra. You need the pickpockets too. There are only as many as pickpockets in the world as are needed. The money that people have... Let's take a break now. Are they doing some kind of an opening? You know, are they open? Please... In this break, they are now opening up something new. Now people are singing Dada Bhagwan Na Simje Jai Kar Ho. Something new being presented. So Dada Bhagwan Na Simje Jai Kar is being sung. We don't know what there is going to be announced, but we'll find out. Somebody singing Dada Bhagwan Na Simje Jai Kar Ho only, solo. And that's Ajit Bhai, our senior Mahatma, coming and taking the blessings of Srimada Swami and Dada Shri and the Devs and the Devis, because he is going to unfold another gift and hand it to the Gnani, or is giving something in blue, especially wrapped to the Gnani. But before he does that, he's going to take it to Niruma and the Devis too, the celestial beings too. Getting blessings from Ma Padmavati and getting the blessings from Ma Niruma and Dada, and the blessings from Ma Amba, and as he approaches our Gnani, then now everybody is singing. And Deepak Bhai is doing the Vidhi for this product that is going to be given to the world. Everybody singing. The Vidhi continues. દાદા ભગવાનના અસીમ જય જયકાર હો. And he touches it to his forehead, the special spot of Punyai, opens up the blue ribbon and takes out a DVD or a VCD or an audio CD of Dada Shri. Hindi is in Hindi. Hindi and Marathi satsang. Satsang in Aurangabad, Bhilai, Chennai, etc. This is a combination of satsang of our Gnani Deepak Bhai in Hindi in different parts of India outside Gujarat. These are all 5 CDs, DVDs in Hindi and Marathi. Marathi is another major language. It's the language of the people around Bombay and the state of Maharashtra, west of India. And in Hindi and Marathi, Hindi all over in this. So now we have this amazing. Deepak Bhai is very fluent in Marathi because he was studied in Bombay, which is where Marathi is spoken also apart from Hindi. Now let us take a break now, huh? Let us take a break. Taking a break. So we save this. This is the evening session.
જીવન છે પાપ પુણ્યનું ફળ જરા કિતાબ ખોલીને જો જીવન છે પાપ પુણ્યનું ફળ જરા કિતાબ ખોલીને જો બંને છૂટવાટે જ્ઞાનીના શબ્દ તોલીને જો બંનેથી છૂટવા માટે જ્ઞાનીના શબ્દ તોલીને જો ત્યાંથી જ છે સવાર. गनावे वाल्मीक लुटारानी हृदय ना पश्चातापो तो बनावे वाल्मीक लुटारानी बुद्धि ती लूट करी गणी कुदरत दंडे नठाराने बुद्धि ती लूट करी गणी कुदरत दंडे नठाराने खरा भगवान ने ओड़त बिराजे जे मई तारी खरा भगवान ने ओड़त बिराजे छे मही तारी तू पोतिज छे परम आत्मा नती तू कदीय देह तारी तू पोतिज छे परम आत्मा नती तू कदीय देहधारी नती तू कदीय देहधारी छता ज्ञान अंधकारे ज्योत शाशितै तारी छता ज्ञान अंधकारे जुओ दशासी थई तारी दादाई ज्ञान पामीले खुली चे मोक्षी एक बारी दादाई ज्ञान पामीले खुली चे मोक्षी एक बारी बेलाड़ी दे तू जग काजे आएक दीदी तो बलवानो बेलाड़ी दे तू जग काजे आएक दीदे तो बलवानो पंचाग्नातारी कर मुख पाओ नक्ती छे मोक्ष मलवानो पंचाग्नातारी कर मुख पाओ नक्ती छे मोक्ष मलवानो नक्ती छे मोक्ष छे पाप पुण्य नु फल जरा किताब खोली ने जो बने ती छूटवा माटे नानी ना शब्द तोली ने जो जय सचिदानंद जय सचिदानंद
अंतरनाशय मादा शुद्धात्मानो
She is singing that, "Oh Dada, I want to become free from this world and I want to go straight to moksha." There are some errors in the words that are being sung, so I'm not translating for them. We are in the break session of August, the evening session of August 27th, 2014, Parayan Aptavani 7, happening right now in Simla city, India, near Gandhinagar, Ahmedabad, in the city of Gujarat of India. Okay. Now we are going to go into the Q&A sessions here now. Instructions being given about how you have to write your full name and where you are from when you submit a question. And Rishi Vignani taking a sip of glove water here, or whatever is specially made for him. Hello, let us take some questions now. Jasmine Dedia, Mayur, Manjula Gamin, Rajkot, Manjuvira, Bhavani Shankar, Madhubai Gajera, Mumbai. So, we have the questions already there, awaiting now the people. Let us speak up. And there's a lot of echo in this question. Very loud. What is your name? He has a little Mayur Bhai Khadik. The worldly interactions should be such that kashayas are supposed to be taken to be uprooted. Our vyavahar, worldly interaction is such that there is no kashayas. Mahatmas, their interaction is without kashayas. But you know, Mahatmas suppose. Mahatmas are, when people do penance, like external penance, fast, things like that, to avoid kashayas, to get the energy, so they will not do kashayas. So, but you see, that is a karmic path. But when they get something wrong in their food, they immediately counteract the other person and end up doing the kashayas. So, the whole idea was to become free from your questions. My question is, Aptamani 3, page 26, my question. Whether you renounce with rag or whether you renounce with dvesh, you will have the reaction, the pudgal will bring it back to you, because whenever you reject something with scorn, it will never get it again. What is the pudgal karamat? What is the play of the pudgal? Our the karma is such that if your intention spoiled, then you will have the reaction. That which you have scorned or kicked, you take it up again through rag, and that you have taken up through rag, you will have to let go through dvesh. And so this is the play of the pudgal. This is a part. The pudgal gets charged according to our intentions, our intent, view and outlook. Grant me the energy to remain in the five agnas. Deepak says, barobar che, that is correct. Next one. Manubhai Gajera, Jai Sachidanand. There is a sutra of Krupadu Dev. You see, if your complications in life are, Dada has said that, Dada she says that your anger, greed, deceit and pride are the one who are giving you. But I feel that there is similarity between Krupadudev and Dada Shri Krupadudev. Krupadudev says that for those who have a lot of, the life is short and the world is very long and the worldly problems are very long, so therefore decrease your entanglements with the world. But that is for the people of Kramic path. But in the Akram path, now you have been made a Shuddhatma. You do not have to shorten your life, whether it is long or short. Life problems, just do not enter into them at all. You just want to settle the life problems with that equanimity. Whatever comes in front of you, you are just supposed to settle in equanimity, in akram. Whereas in the kramic path of Krupadudev Srimad Rajchandra, you have to actively do something to decrease your entanglements and complications of life. If you're doing a business, you have to close down your business, etc., slowly. But whereas here, here there is no pushing away of the files. Settling with the file with equanimity means you settle rag as well as settle dvesh also with equanimity. You know, whether there are rag situations, where there are pleasant situations, you don't push them away. And where there is dvesh situations, you don't push them away. You look at them squarely in the eye and be the self only. But when it comes again, then when the awareness comes back again, then I will have. So this keeps on. No. What is in your intention to settle the file with equanimity? If you have the intention to settle with equanimity, then for sure, you know, the accounts of the Pudgal will finish and you will remain in equanimity. Equanimity is the critical thing. Next one, Varsha Doshi and Ami Patel, two more being announced. And Parul from Ahmedabad. Kanaka from Chennai. Kanaka from Chennai. Madras is the other name for it. Praveena Makwana from Mumbai, Bombay. And one more. Minal Kamdar, Ahmedabad. Jai Sachidanand Deepak Bhai. In After 3, Dada says, sometimes when you don't want to get burnt, you get burnt. Before Gnanvidhi, there were all kinds of intentions. What will happen? Most of them will get burnt. You have given a lot of orders to the city of Ahmedabad that, you know, I want to do this, I'm going to come back. But if you move from Ahmedabad to Baroda, all those orders will get cancelled, right? If you're given a lot of business orders, because your location changed, before you were sitting in the relative, therefore most of it is gone through Pratikraman and Pratakyan. By coming into the self, in the real, most of them is gone. But sometimes, however, if some desires are still bothering you, then do the pratyakhyan for it, and you'll be, for desire there is pratyakhyan, and for memory of pain there is pratikraman. Next one. I have a million namaskars to Pujya Shri. Dada says that love should be without any selfish intent. When I want to come to satsang, when for satsang, for Dada's work, is it okay to be selfish for Dada's work? Is it okay? Why do you want to keep a selfish intent? Then you just have the intention. You don't need the selfish intent. You just have to have just the intention for. Ghat means that there is, you see, ghat means there is selfishness. But if you have the bhavana that I want to go to satsang, the circumstances will arise for you. And these people will support you. And you see, so if you don't use the word ghat. Ghat is a worldly selfish intent. The one who wants to take advantage of other people, you see. And it is not to be used for this side only. Now that yesterday, what Dimple Bhai said yesterday, that you should not hurt anyone, it touched me so much that I do not want to, that I am making the firm decision that I do not want to hurt anyone, that I want to clear up this level of where I am hurting other world. Please grant me the energies. Thank you. Next one. Dimple Bhai just need not to, just say Jai Sachidanand to that answer. There are six eternal things. Eternal, the elements are also called things by Dada, Vastu, because they are permanent. The Chaitanya Tattva is eternal. Then there are five other eternal elements too. Next one. Jai Sachidan Dada. She addresses him as Dada. Jai Sachidan, I have come here for the first time. What is your name? My daughter becomes very angry. So what should I do? Bring her to satsang is the answer. And you come and bring her. Then the solution will come. Yeah. And my husband eats a lot of masalas. Masalas is the tobacco that is spiced, you see. and kept in the mouth that leads to oral and tongue cancer, you see. If you do not like it, you just, you know, apply the four steps. Oh, Dada Bhagwan, grant him the energy, teach him the four steps of how to become free from smoking, how to become free from this chewing tobacco. Kanakacharni. About the abuse and the use of authority, in my work, I am very abusive to others. Then stop the misuse and the abuse, and then you'll be left with only the good use, right? Stop hurting others, then the good use will start. When you hurt others, then of course, she is talking about her authority with her own husband about, you know, do not hurt him when he has lost his job. My husband, this is his last date in Hyderabad, and he has got another job, but because of grace of Dada, he has got another job. She is a South Indian from Hyderabad. But until he gets the new job, you should not be really hurting him or, you know, jabbing him or making verbal jabs at him. What's happening to your job? What are you not doing this? Why aren't you looking for it? How is the money going to come to us? I said, do not hurt him through words. Be positive. Make sure and proceed in such a way that he does not get hurt. You know, in any matters between a husband and a wife, there should be no negativity between the husband and the wife, you see. You should be supportive to each other, and we should be empathetic to each other. You should be considerate of each other. You should be, and in the same way, towards other people in the home, whether it is your parents, in-laws, or your children. Do not find faults with them. That is, you compliment each other, be supportive to each other in their problems that are arising. If they become angry, or if they just accept it and make the adjustment that it happened because of his prakriti, they are pure only, they are very good people. There is Sachidana. Next one. Yes, Sachidana Deepak Bhai. Harsha Ben Doshi. A million namaskars to you. What should samayik pratikraman and five agnas and awareness is necessary to attain moksha first, or to go into details of gnan? The five agnas and pratikraman, samayik and awareness is more important, and satsang, agna five, is more important. But about all this subtle talk, I cannot grab this very subtle talk. It is only for those who are want to check the fuses and wiring the whole thing. The electricians, you see, they want to see how everything is wired. It is not necessary. You should be just enjoying the fan and the breeze that comes through the fan. You should not be concerned about how is everything connected. You are 100% correct. Five agnas, VVPS is important. Now she is just asking a detailed question. Now immediately she is asking a detailed question. Yes, sir. But if somebody is asking detailed questions, you should not have negative feelings toward that person, or your feelings should not be obsessed. Your intention or view or outlook should not change from the rhinocelia to, oh, why is he doing that? Why is he doing that? You see, it should not move from the view of the pragna to the view of the intellect. It should not happen. Through this that has been prescribed to you, which is five agnas, VVPS, and there will be beautiful path and towards liberation and final moksha. And, you know, and also do the Jagat Kalyan Bhavana. She is not listening. So sometimes I feel that, you know, when I'm not going into the details, I feel that I'm getting left out. No, don't feel get left out. That is itself the problem. Focus on the positive. They are understanding it so beautiful. Therefore, they are understanding because they are going to share this Vignan with this world. So let it happen. Yes. With the right vision, there is moksha for sure, right? Yes. Make sure that you settle all files with equanimity. That is the most critical thing. Agna 4. What are the six eternal tattva? This is one. They are all eternal elements. That last question. Next one. Yes, Sachidana. Hinal Kamdar, yesterday, the samayik that you made us do, I got my answer, but I still have the feeling that, but when I meet someone, I don't know whether it's an internal greed or not, but there is, but I hurt the other person. But I say, I feel that he'll be useful to me, but I know, but I say, give him respect, you see. You should notice that that is the junk within file one only, and then ask her, what is it that you want out of that person, that you are complimenting that person or trying to kind of be in his good sides, etc. You see, so a month later when you find it, you will not find even that. Most of it is just, you know, sometimes, many times, you know, you accumulate things in life, but that, you know, it will be useful, it will be useful, it will be useful. And when you look later on, you'll find, oh, I had collected this tool or this thing because it will be useful. It is the nature of the prakriti to collect everything. We are not in the business. Yes, if you have some business where you need all of these things, yes. If your business contexts are such that, you know, you need such people's help, then it is different. But, you know, you don't need to be, it is not your business to proceed in that direction by having contacts, then you don't really need to worry. Everyone at home is Mahatmas of Dada, but for, you know, I've taken Gnan for only 2.5 years, therefore I wonder when I will be at their level, because, no. It says all of these people here are about 20 years old, they are 25 years old in Gnan, you see, and I'm discussing it, and this is all. What they are getting at 20 years, after 20 years of satsang, you are getting it within 2 years. Or within a year or two you are getting. So you should be very, very blessed if you're thinking that what these people, Mahatmas, are getting after 20 and 25 years, you are getting instantly within a shibir. Isn't that amazing? Jai Sachidanand, Parul, Pune. Jai Sachidanand. I already have my answer, but you know, periodically the field stock is coming out, and then of course I... But occasionally Parul spoils her intentions and sends the negative vibrations to others. So I want to get your blessing that I want to do VVPS and your prank, and then I want to settle all file wise. Grant me those energies only. There was no question. She was just asking. So, but you see, sir, I can see this. But you see, I have been attending Parayan for long, but this is the best Parayan. But I feel that this is the best kind of, I have done so many samayik of sexuality but I was able to see the in samayik when I'm very grateful to you for this thing, because I want to see, and there is no suffering at all. Even though I'm seeing a lot, there is no suffering inside. So this is okay. Deepak Bhai did not go and say next one. It was a compliment, so Deepak Bhai did not respond much. There was no question there. It was just a comment. Okay, now. Patel Darshna Godhra. Karthik Tandel, Valsad. Speak up, please. Jai Sachidanand. Which question of mine is there in your hand? The one you had sent. The one that you sent. There was a question about an event of pride that carried on for 3 years. At once I was not respected properly, I was not given proper respect, and I was so much in trouble. But for 3 years I was affected. Somebody disrespected you. People around you know, in seva, when I was doing service, I was not respected, and therefore 3 years I had all kinds of inner turmoil. It took 3 months. I saw negative of the people that I was working with for in seva, in service. But now, again, when the event comes in, again it kind of arises within me. And therefore, I knew that it was my own hunger for pride only inside, but I could not really become free from the storm. The thought will come that I say that, you know, I will do employ deceit to get the pride. Then I realize that the one man, that pride that I want to get rid of, I don't want to employ deceit here. Therefore, I don't want. And then I was feeling helpless, I was feeling terrible in all of this. Dada is there. Did you forget Dada? Did you forget Dada and Niruma? I was seeing. He says, Did you not go to Simanda Swami? Hajra Hajur is living, Dada is present. Why don't you go upstairs, you know? Why are you worried about what's going to happen to me? Dada is there, Simandar Sahani is there. Oh Lord, with the exception of moksha, I don't want anything. When the nature is doing your operation, you are complaining. And the Gnani will sooner or later says, but you are affected because they did not respect you, but they did respect you for somewhat, but some they treated me with less respect than I thought I should deserve in the service. But you know, you're so hungry, you want 50 cheesecakes and you want to eat them all at the same time. Why don't you really become the pure soul and then kind of scold this woman that why she is doing like this, you see, in service especially, why is she behaving like this? Why don't you scold her from inside? Because when other people tell you, you do not have the capacity to listen, then why don't you begin scolding her, you see? Then when you keep her aside, keep her in a corner and punish her. Because, you know, do not have the capacity to listen to other people scolding you. When later on, yes, I recognize that I have this deep, intense hunger for the 50 cheesecakes, but even then, I did not have the knowledge of how to, but about 10 days ago, I was able to separate and then I was able to feel a little bit of my bliss, and therefore, with this particular thing, that I feel that I was a little separate from this desire to be respected, you see. And if you read the pages of Aptavanis of Dada, on every page Dada is there. But Deepak Bhai, there was so much that happened inside that nothing would work. But you know, in 3 years I lost so much, but at the end you have come of one. You are able to stand and openly display it in front of everyone. Isn't that a major achievement? That means your internal penance has come to a result. It is good. But I have a little heavy storm of pride within. This is called extreme pride, extreme hunger. You want to eat 56 cheesecakes of pride, feeding your pride, not just one cheesecake. You are not satisfied until you want to eat all the 56 cheesecakes. Next one. Nandan Karthik. Next one. On page 189, Dada says, if you are very, very evil, then if you are negative towards the Gnani, you'll go straight to hell and then you'll go straight to heaven, then come back and then attain Gnan, and then yes, as we understand, therefore this human birth is a junction. Here we can bind karma or we can become free. How does it happen that one goes to deep hell and deep heavens and then comes back? It has already happened to you. But you see, how does it connect you? She says that ultimately when you fight with the Vitarag, ultimately you will attain moksha. But you know, you should be concerned with your Gnan, with five Gagnas. You know, Dada has said that. Next one. Harita Shah, next one. Jai Sachid. My problem is that I'm a lawyer and then I have clients in court. Then I had to fight with my own family members because my family members were involved in my civil cases or clients in the court. When I do pratikraman, I know this is wrong, that I'm hurting them, but when I do pratikraman, at the same time, the intellect is constantly showing where they are wrong. So I am doing pratikraman by seeing them at fault. I am doing pratikraman one side, but I continue to see their fault. But then I warn her that you are doing the pratikraman the wrong way, because there is no way, no manner in doing pratikraman. If there is no role of pratikraman when you see the other person at fault, So what should I do? I see faults when I am doing pratikraman. Are you reading the speech of Dada? Do you get a little time? Read that. Read the book, The Flawless Vision. There is, just read one or two pages every day, then or watch the VCD, the Parayan of Nich Dosh Darshan, then the intellect. Because your intellect has so many evidences, because it's like a lawyer, that in what way the other person is at fault. And slowly, as you read the words of Gnani Purush Dada Shri, all of this will happen, your intellect will subside, and then it will let you do pratikraman properly. And then let you come into the awareness of the self and the awareness of the self of the other person before you do pratikraman. That is all. Next one, Krupa. I am so surrendered when I am doing service. But file 2 has the ego. She's talking about my husband is so strong. I am very mild prakriti that I cannot change, but my husband has got a very strong prakriti. And so, you see, I am always surrendered to my husband. Therefore, talk to your own self, you see. That is all. And so, just talk to some of the Aptaputris and find out what's going on. Okay, now next one. Arsa Dhoraniya Surat. Namrata Shah Rajkot. A while ago, it happened to me that I went into deep depression. And then Chirag Bhai and Raksha Ben, they helped me a lot. And the Aptaputra and Aptaputri, they helped me a lot. But even then, inside, there is some depression remains. And then I concentrated a lot on Dada Vani's and speech of Dada. But every day my intellect would show me faults of others, of some nimit or the other. But as soon as the day starts again, I see faults of other people and again I reset the Gnan. But again I had dvesh reactions. But it would decrease, but not enough to the point where I would get some degree of harmony and peace within. And in Parayan on the first day, I did Samayik. And then I realized that I am not this. Why am I in suffering? Ever since this Parayana started and these Samayaks have started, I have realized that I am not this. And therefore, then I realized that nothing has happened. This was all invited pain only. Why was I suffering unnecessarily? Everything is blank now. I don't have any suffering at all. And I am in a lot of... But then I have heard that after all the Parayana ends, then again it will restart. So then I want this same thing to remain every day. And all this has happened in the 6 days. I want to remain for the rest of my life. So what should I do? If you remain here in if you live in Simanda city, do the aarti every day and then take the homework every day. And then if you need to meet, then meet her every day. You meet the Aptaputri, then recognize that that Rita's moh is burning, the Rita's illusory attachment is burning, it is Rita's depression. When it is happening to somebody, would you be hurt? No. When it is happening to somebody, you won't be hurt. Similarly, it is not happening to you, it is happening to this first neighbor that is called Rita or whatever her name is. You see, so it is all happening. So now celebrate, all the junk is gone. Now bad stuff will not come. Deepak Bhai is energizing her because of her depression, by the way. And you see, nothing negative will happen. You should just forget. You see, just be in bliss, be in positive attitude. And then always listen to the Sonari Prabhat Satsang, the Golden Morning Satsang. Every day it will fill you up with tremendous energy. Just listen to the Sonari Prabhat. Sonari Prabhat is the Golden Morning Satsang. It will fill you with so much energy. So do that. Listen to them and everything will become fine. Deepak Bhai being very kind to her because of her depression. Next one. One day Dada came in my dream and said, "You have very little time. Get your work done." What should I understand? What is Dada trying to tell me? That means... And you do not have 200 to 300 years, you see. You won't only, even out of 100 years, 25 years is gone. Now, if you've got about 5, 10, 15 or 20 years, 50 years left, get your work done as you are in this body. Because, do you think you're going to get a life extension of 200 years lifespan? You will not get it and I will not get it. So we just have to get the work done with whatever time we have left. The right use of the time in this body is critical, you see. At the most, any human being gets about 100 years, but 70, 80, 100 years. So the important thing is to get the work done as we are in this body. Do you see? How many years have you taken Gnan? 10 to 12 years? This is one-third is gone now, right? Now, one-third of your life is gone. He asked her his age, but the important thing is be aware, never hurt anyone. Even if the intention arises, move away from it. I want to clear it up. I want to clear the file and move forward. I want to be in Mahavidya Kshetra with the living Lord in front of Him only. I do not want to block my moksha in any way. I want to progress as the S capital Self in the direction of moksha only. And I want to go to Lord Simandhar only and nowhere else. He is my protector and the ultimate liberator. I want to go to my Lord only. That is all. Be in that awareness. I don't want to keep coming back in this world. I don't want to hurt another one. So I do not want to prolong my time on this earth unnecessarily. Unnecessarily. The accounts of the body will finish on their own. Let it finish, you see. Finish with equanimity. That is all. But the mind requires certain food. But when it doesn't get what it needs, then there is a sense of suffocation. And then just purchase these DVDs and things and then watch these VCDs. There are so many. There is so many new ones that open. And then, you know, some great ones have been opened up in this paraya. And purchase them and listen to them, you see, and see them. Next one. When I cannot fulfill the expectations that the other person has for me, and I am willing to do everything that he wants me to do, but he still finds faults with me, then what should I do? The first of all, the most important thing is, then you see, you should get rid of the feeling that, why is he expecting so much from me? Why is he expecting? In the last moment, I do everything, at the last minute, he demands something from me. In the last, you know, he is constantly changing. I have made all kinds of adjustments, but the last moment he changes. But it is, no, it's just, and don't we have a GPS in the car, you know, the GPS will tell you, take left on, but supposing you have missed the exit, then the GPS will make you turn all around. So you should be like the GPS. The GPS does not find faults with you just because you took the wrong, you did not follow the instructions, right? The best thing is become the GPS for yourself, you see. You know, become like a GPS. Just, you know, get rid of all these negativities, dvesh reactions, suffocation, you see. You know, I do not want to spoil my intention. I want to be in equanimity, samabhav. I do not want to be in any other bhav except samabhav, equanimity. This is your agreement with him in the last life, and that is why in the last life you told him, be with me and I'll take care of you. Now he is with you and now you are not taking care. You are defaulting on your own contract. You are finding faults with him. This is the contract that you had made with him, your husband, in the last life. And but you see, you know, but now if you follow 50% of the contract and the 50% don't follow, then you'll get another life of 50-50 only. Why don't you clear up your account with him in this life only? Why don't you just not complain and settle with equanimity? Do not have any intentions. She says it's very hard to really do this, what you're telling me. I'm adjusting everywhere. He simply is not. Just wonder, wow, what have you done in the past life that you got somebody like him in this life? That he is always finding faults with you and always expecting you to be better and better and better. What the hell is going on? The fault is all yours only, is it not? So, you know, be prepared that if the last minute he says do this and he do that, you should be teary. You know, when he tells me the last minute, you don't have to go, he treats me like a servant. That is called entering into penance, because by fighting, you're not going to get anything out of it, you see. Enter into penance. Just think, I will do it. Okay, I'll do it. No, but you should be gentle with him. I'll finish everything. Let me go for half an hour and then I'll come back. Apparently, he finds fault with her for coming to satsang, etc. You know, so many years you already passed with him, so finish the rest of the time with him. No. Because I'm lacking something. Dada, please, you know, I'm done with all the energies. I don't have any energy to deal with this guy anymore. Dada, please help me. And do not expect him to improve, because there is at a very subtle level you're expecting him to improve. This is your account. You should accept him as your account only from previous life, you see. You know, the winter will never improve for you. All you have to do is to wear a jacket if you're shivering, you see. And you want to make adjust everywhere, adjust with him. I want to make all the adjustments. Does he come to the satsang at all? Deepakva is asking, does he come to satsang? She doesn't answer. Does he come to the satsang? No, not you. I'm asking. Yes, he came 2 days in Tara. He came for 2 days in this para and then went away. But you know, he came, but then he went away. If he came for 2 days, the water will fill in him. So you have to employ the techniques whereby he will come to satsang. You tell him, I'll take care of the home. You go. Right? So 2 days is a very positive thing that he came to this shibir at least. So You know, 2 days, whatever went inside him will work at a very subtle level, and his prakruti will melt for sure. Please help me, Deepak Bhai, please help me. And he is so interested, he is so addicted to news and newspapers. No, why are you worried about that? And again, now we are complaining about his watching news. What's going on with you, lady? You know, you just send a positive energies to his pure soul, said that let him come. Dada, grace him in such a way that he comes to satsang. That we go to satsang together. We would like to go to satsang together. Okay. No. Deepak Bhai. Million namaskars at your feet, Deepak Bhai. You give every day the samayiks you give are extraordinary samayiks, and there's a new modes of samayik. And you see, because when you said that, you know, that he is, when a man suffers, he is so much caught in the illusion that I'm over and this is what I want. That is why they're suffering. But if he can see that this is of Uwe and this is where Uwe is suffering, this is how he's over suffering, but let him have my understanding, I am the Raina Zile. But as I go deeper into the Samayik, that it is on the basis of the merit karma of previous life that this has a definite role in this. As I look in the suffering, because all environments that are conducive and good, it is a result of merit karma. He's speaking very fast, but I want to, especially for the seniors and elders and Niruma and Dada and you, sir, I want to respect and revere you. But until then, I used to think that I am doing it, I am taking it, and I am being, it has been replaced, my doership has been replaced by the correct understanding that you all have given me. And before that, I used to take the credit for anything good that happened. But now I am getting the new vision that, you know, that I used to have the, I'm better. I used to climb the high horse of the ego and I was hurting other people because of this, seeing their negative things. That was the wrong issues of pride. But now this is, I know that this is all wrong. This is all dead wrong, and I want to accept your vision completely. Very good. Deepak Bhai says that is the correct vision. I also want to ask that, I use the word guthana, the spiritual stage in satsang. I want to understand what is this. Guthana means gunsthanak. It is a spiritual stage. The self is of infinite knowledge and vision, but how much has it manifest in your worldly self? Then it says first stage, second stage, third spiritual stage, fourth stage. When you pass sexuality, you have crossed the ninth gunsthanak, ninth spiritual stage. The 12th gunsthanak, the 12th spiritual level, is the experience of the soul has input. And in the 13th level of spiritual stage, you are in absolute knowledge. And in 14th, you get into nirvana and you go to moksha. This is the gunsthanak, means the spiritual stage, means the energies of the self are manifesting in the mind-body complex. You see, in conduct. When sexuality leaves you, you have just crossed ninth gunsthanak. However, Jnanvidhi, you enter into the fifth and the sixth, you see. Enter the fifth. After the Jnanvidhi, you are in the 12th. You see, and after the Jnanvidhi and Nishya, you are in the 12th. But in worldly interaction, you are at the fifth or the sixth, wherever you are. And once you pass sexuality, you have crossed 9. Once you pass greed, you have crossed 10th. In an 11th, okay, why are the souls in the celestial life only? Well, they cannot escape their karma, they cannot attain freedom in the celestial realm. They have to come back as a human being and then get to know who you are before you can attain liberation. They have infinite bliss over there. Infinite pleasures over there. Next one. Speak up, ma'am. I think the microphone has gone to the wrong. Okay, now she is speaking. Jai Sachidan. Darshana Patel. 2011, I did take Gnan. I was in Kramik, so it was a hard time to get let go of the Kramik step by step. I have a very low level of Gnan, but I have the goal of Mahavide. when how much should I, how much time should I spend on the soul, and how much time should I spend for the world, and how many hours should I spend on the soul? I want to know how much time I should spend. From 10:15 till 5 o'clock, I have a primary job. I have a job. I do Charan Vidhi. I do Asim Jai Jaikar, 15 minutes. I do 108 times Tri Mantra. No, only 5 times in the morning and 5 times in the evening. That's all you need to do Tri Mantra. You don't need to do it 100 times. And then do Pratikraman. And I do Pratikraman 5 times. Don't count. You see, this is the Kramik path. She is apparently a Jain. In all day, who have you? And at right, when I go to bed, how many times? At one time, increase the Pratikraman for having hurt the people in the day. And then I do the Namaskar. I do it occasionally. I can do Nisimanda Swami Namaskar 108 times. Occasional. That is good. And then I do all the 8 Aartis. And I light a lamp and then I do it inside within me. And I do Simada Swami and I do Dada Dharti. She is doing all the prescriptions. How can I progress it further? Beyond that, now find out the sticky file. Clear up your sticky file. That I want to, I do not want heavy, a single file remain pending. And I want to settle the file with equanimity. Again, Deepakbhai pulled her into the Agnas only. And I want to become free from the Stri Prakruti, the femaleness that is there. I cannot see anything. Then are you not going to the young women's satsang? I get there. I only go to the local satsang. Why don't you start going to the satsang for ladies also? Then you will get the... But I cannot see in Samayik, but even recently only. But I only see very little. But then I sleep in Samayik. Then, and then wake up and then do it again. You see, then see it. You know, wake up and see. Grant me the energies. I want to finish all my accounts in this life and I want to reach Mahavidikshetra, please. Yes, very good, correct. This is Deepakbhai. Next one. Bharat Shah Bhavnagar. I have given, received my answer, but... Okay, so he didn't ask the question. Next one. Veena Manik Bharuch, next one being announced. And this lady is now being asking her question. If I get anything according to my desire, then it is on the result of my merit karma only. But if we help others because of what I have, is it good? Where does it go? Yeah, go ahead and do it. What are the results of that? But when I look in Samayik, I find that the ego arises. And then slowly then settle with equanimity, because ego should not arise because of your merit karma. If your facilities and if you are hurting others, and then you just settle the prakruti, the file one with equanimity, you see. You file one is supposed to see if she is hurting someone, you see. It is file one only. He says the helping others or hurting others is the account of file one. Settle it with equanimity only. Will any of that carry forward if I am helping others? No, only the five Agnas. What her question was, if I help others, will it be carry forward? People will appreciate you here, but it will not be carried forward in the next life. Do you want to carry any of these things? No, only five Agnas is the only thing that will carry forward. You see, let the Prakruti finish here. You see, she wants to help and also carry forward. Nothing carry forwards except the five Agnas. I do Samayik. When I sit in Samayik, at that time, everything goes blank in Samayik for me. No. Is that just right now? You just said that I don't help anyone, I don't take anyone's help, and nor do I want to help anyone. All of those things. See, find out where is. Have you hurt anyone? Have you seen errors of anyone? Have you had negative thoughts about somebody? And if you don't like it, then at least see the pure soul only. It is your intellect that will see the negative of somebody or the other. Find out where you have missed the five Agnas and see everybody's pure soul. See the pure souls of everybody that you met. And then find out where you have missed everything. And then find out, receipt, and then set the Agna of Yavasthit. You see? And who will can we consider a file? Find out, you see? And then you see, then find out whether there was any kind of visham bhav, lack of equanimity, rag dvesh with anyone, where there should have been equanimity of the self only. When I do the samayik, when I do the samayiks here, I am totally filled with bliss, and there is tremendous wonder for everything. Wow, what? But then I want, then I go home, you see, and they do. But my samayiks are incomplete. So then, so before, good samayik used to happen, but now they have revived again. Jai Sachidanand. Next one. Veena Manek and Chitra Goyal. On page 192, the Adarshi says that where everybody is a fool, let them call you a fool, but you should not mind, you should not have it that you, his, when everybody, the entire world is a fool and stupid, then you know, just if, then you know, you, then what? But if five or seven of them tell you that you are a fool, then you, your belief spoils and therefore you enter into kashyas. And then, you know, and then he is reading from Atmani that the world is our mirror only, and it is the mirror of our ego. Yes, you see, when somebody tells you that you are wrong, if somebody tells, if you are going to satsang, and then if somebody says that you are going to the wrong thing, then you have to, but then it is okay. But, you know, then you have to say that, no, I gain something out of here. But somebody accuses you that you are wrong in some way. Find out in what manner are people accusing you. So make use of the ego when world find faults with you. That is the mirror of your own ego. They are telling you what is wrong with you. And so let you see. It allows you to see what is wrong with you. But I feel that you know, in what matter they're saying it is secondary, but in who is saying it, I'm more affected by it. Because you see, you attack the person who is saying it. You want to, you know, rather than who is saying it, you should be fine investigating where is the junk within Vishal, what is the problem with Vishal that the other person is saying this to him. Next, Urmila Ben. The love without any ghat, selfishness, selfish intent, manipulativeness. Before Gnan, I had employed it quite a bit. Before Gnan. But after Gnan, whoever has met me, I have done pratikraman for that because of my selfish intentions behind them. But I, the second part, I cannot do my, I can't do anything about the ones I met before the Gnanvidhi. And you see, you know, when I have it in my intention that when I invite them, they should come. When I tell other people, you see, the best way to talk to other people is to give them the books of Dada and also the TV satsang in my, we'd like to have a center in our town also. Will you please talk to the coordinators. One close file passed and he loved you very much. He wanted to do darshan, but because of illness he could not come. He died without doing it. Deepak Bhai says he will come back here to do the darshan even though he has died. He will come here. Yes. Next one, Jai Sachidan. From between Guru Purnima until now, my intellect has bothered me so much, but I feel like giving up the service. But my intellect, what is your name? Meena Manek Bhar. She is having a hard time in service. No. Yes. I think, what do you want to say? You know, but I have hurt a lot of people in service. I'm asking for your forgiveness, and that I don't want to see anything negative about the people who are serving with me. And on what? And then also investigate why. What is the reason why these mistakes arise? Yeah, it is because, and in Samayik I saw that whatever I did is coming. Therefore, do pratyakhyan for it, and then I ask for Dada. Dada, I want to remain positive for everyone. And I want to serve in the Jagat Kalyan of Dada. And Niruma also used to tell me that, why didn't you accept? And yes, I'm accepting it now. And then Niruma told me that as long as you are there, you will serve until the left. But yes, you are allowed to do service, but you should not fight and you should not file anybody's mistakes. Grant me the energy to remain in five agnas and do service. Okay, correct. Now let us now talk about Samayik, and then we'll take the remaining questions later with the Samayik. Now, on this evening of August 27th, this is about boss and servant. You know, the abuse of authority as a boss. When you have everyone has somebody under him in worldly interactions only, some places where you are underhand, where you are in very near in an inferior position, and somewhere you are in a superior position in the worldly life. This is the nature of life. Even at home also, when you say I don't work, but you know, are you not a boss of your children and on your maid? You are a boss of your maid, so that means you are bossing over your maid. And so whatever your belief, and you see, whatever your belief is, tends to hurt. Then find out what is the kind of a role that you have for those who are underneath you. How are you treating them? You know, whether you are a boss, then how much have you protected those who are below you, or how much have you hurt them? And then the businessmen have a lot of that in worldly interactions in business. You know, you have to hire people who were to work underneath you, and when they are, you will find some who are not doing anything. Four are doing good work, but the other two are constantly interfering. At that time, you have to investigate where you became upset with them, and then you try to slowly manipulate them so that you can fire them. Because of your greed for money only, that means you have hurt them, or therefore you hurt. So find out where, because of your own underlying kasha, is you have mistreated them, abused them. When you are a department head, as the head of the department, where you have mistreated human beings, fired them, where for the people who have not done things, because you have to talk to your boss properly, you have to give a right answer. So where you really abuse the ones who are below you, because they cannot do the work problem, when the work underneath you is not done properly, you hurt them. So these are all very critical things. Here also, when we had the work of the temple, when the Adalat's Srimandir was being built, you see there were all the three domes were still remaining. The bricks had not been laid, and 6 weeks were left, and all the three domes of the three mandir of Adalat were without bricks. Can you believe it? And at that time, it was very difficult. And the work was of 3 months duration, and we had to finish it within 1.5 months. Niruma was very positive. And she then doubled. And then she fed all the servants. Every evening she started special food for all of this thing. All the servants, including tea and snacks and everything. That so many people came for the work even the night, and also of course they were getting the double pay, and they were getting the nice pay also. And so the work that was done, that needed to be done in 3.5 months, finished in 1.5 months, and the mandir, the three mandir, was ready for the pran pratishtha at the right time in 2001. So this is how it is. If we take care of those who are underneath us, they will take care of us. Bossism is dead wrong. If those who are working underneath us, we should be aware of their difficulties. He says we should find, if he is not doing the work, find out what is the evidence that is lacking, what is not, what is the facility. Some servants have got so many of their own problems that they have a hard time working in your own kitchen or in your own work. So find out what is bothering them and give them the right understanding. Because Vyavasthit is finishing their work, you are not, but you say, you're stupid, you're late, you're never coming this, you're a calm chore, you're always not doing your work. You see, you're taking the money, but you're not doing your share of the work. Calm chore. You're a thief in work, you see. And then he gets negative feelings against you, and then he will also say, what the hell, what do I care, I want to screw up his work, you see, I will take the salary, and he becomes rebellious. And therefore, the heart of the workers go wrong, and then they rebel. Even at a collective level, they rebel. But if your interaction with them is such that he will finish it sincerely, and he will fulfill more than what your expectations are there for me. But the intentions that you spoiled when you hurt him through intentions, or you see him at fault, at that time, And he says, when he is free, he is constantly whiling away his time, he is not doing his work. Don't say anything negative about your own servant to anyone. That means, you know, he will get to know it, because the servant pool will talk to each other like upstairs, downstairs. And so you never be the boss with your workers. You see, just let us check in our life. Then women should so find out that, you know, when they are mistreating their maids, etc., find out where they are mistreating their maids. Everyone has a yes, and you are the boss of your company. Supposing so, then there is so much kach-kach, so much bickering. I'm going to cut your, every other day you're reminding, I'm not going to give you enough money because you're not doing the work. You see, this is the kind of kach-kach that must be avoided, you see. That means her mind gets spoiled and your days get spoiled. So check and find out what is lacking. And if you are an underhand, if somebody is above you, and if he gives you double the work, then you become upset and disturbed. That is wrong, and you curse him, etc., and your intentions spoil, all of that is wrong too. And then I know, and he is not giving the work to others, and he's giving all the work to me, etc. And so, you know, ask for twice the energy and finish your energies, you know, to, you know, so you see, then sooner or later his job will change, your boss will change. But you see, you need to have the right energies within you. This life is to finish the accounts that were created in the last life with equanimity, not with any counterattack or finding faults with him. Whatever it is my own account that I have, this boss, this above me. It is the turban that I have received is the size of my head only, nobody else's. It is with me. The hat is according to the size of my head only. You see, so this is all coming to me. Without spoiling our own intentions, if we spoil, then whatever work happens, then it will finish. This emptying and filling is emptying of the non-self complex. It will finish for sure. But you know, if we are getting the salary out of our hard work as well as our sincere. And we do progress because of sincerity that we have done. But if we really, if you really take shortcuts and you do not do what you're supposed to do, then we are creating our own obstructions in also. So even as an underhand or below somebody, or as a servant, as a subordinate, there is a responsibility then how we should finish our work, and also check on the other side in how am I losing my equanimity and how I am mistreating the person below me. And the third level is such that, and then it's equals, you know, the people who are your coordinators, your own, at your own level, but you're working with them only, those who are your colleagues, you see, then how do you proceed with them, you see? So when the other person is being treated well by his people below him, then you get jealous, and when you are being mistreated, you get jealous. And so you see, whether you are a spiritual colleague, whether you are a boss or an assistant, you do not want to have a slightest worsening of your intent, view, or outlook. The worsening of your intent, view, of outlook is with, I am Uwe, I am Katya, and I am Ishvin Rainasele, he is also Rainasele. There is no worsening of your view or intent or outlook. Bow. You see, the adjustments are automatically going to happen at the relative real level by the right vision that this is all happening. But you see, you need to know who is the doer in here, you see. You see, it is our accounts are spoiled, they were spoiled in the past life, and they are, but you know, right now our responsibility is not to spoil them again by becoming Nada or Uwe or Katya or Marion, you see. So this is how it is. So therefore, there we will not have the slightest disturbance inside us, and we will have perfect equanimity, and the file will be settled. So let us do this samayik. In whatever stage we are in life, with reference to boss, underhand, or a spiritual colleague, or let us take this all in samayik. Everybody understands this? Okay. Let us do the vidhi of the samayik and do a great samayik, okay? Hey Dada Bhagwan, O Absolute Self within me. Hey Sri Simandar Swami Prabhu, the perfect Lord at Mahavidikshetra. With the exact applied awareness of the Self, Shuddha Upyog, in worldly interactions of life, as a boss or with others, with assistants, and as an underhand with the boss, in worldly interactions with him, whatever has happened in world interactions, when mistakes and seeing faults of each other has happened, when pain and hurt has been given to each other, a lack of sincerity has been present in work, and scorn and bad feelings have arisen. Let me see all those mistakes in Samayik, my Lord. Grant me the energy to see all these mistakes, my Lord. Let me reset the five agnas in these situations. Let me settle the accounts of the files. Let me remain in equanimity in those accounts. And let me settle the accounts with Gnan. And let me set such awareness, my Lord. And let me do such Samayik, my Lord. Grant me the energy. I surrender the mind, speech and body. All illusions associated with this name of mine. Bhav karma, charge karma, dravya karma, subtle discharge karma, yellow glasses, no karma. Hey Dada Bhagwan, the Absolute Self within me. Sir, you are the manifest Lord within me. You are the Lord God within me, and it is your divine feet that I am surrendering them all. I am surrendering them all to your feet, my Lord. Hush machu, shuddhat 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 machu. Shuddhatmachu, 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 Osoamapura, Osoamapura. Uso Mapura, Uso Mapura, Uso Mapura, Ish bin Rhino Seele, 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 Shuddhat Machu, Shuddhat Machu, Shuddhat Machu, Shuddhat Machu, Shuddhat Machu, Shuddhat Machu, Shuddhat Machu. Shuddhat machu, 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 jai Sachidanand, jai Sachidanand. In all samayiks, I am pure soul is separate from file 1. And whatever happens, always have the exact samayik in separation only. Never do a samayik through I am Ube, I am Nada. Okay. Now the aarti is going to happen.
अत्यंत भक्तिपूर्वक नमस्कार करूं छूं।